We had learned squares and square root, the definition part. Then we have seen different square numbers, right from 1 to 900. Then we have looked into the properties of square number. The first property was, if the numbers are ending with 3, 7, 8 and 2, they are not perfect squares. The second one was, any number having 1 and 9 at the units place, its square ends with 1. The third property we learned was, the number ending with 4 or 6, its unit place always ends with 6. If the number has got 0 in the units place, then even number of zeros will be there in its square. Followed by, we have learned interesting patterns like adding triangular numbers. The second was finding non-perfect square numbers between two square numbers. And we ended the class with the third one, adding odd numbers. Every square number is a combination of odd numbers. If consecutive 7 odd numbers are there, its square will be 49. This was the last one.
Yes, sir.
Yes,
yes,
we,
sir.
We shall continue with the fourth one. A sum of consecutive natural numbers. What does this sum of consecutive natural numbers refers to?
It means every square number is made up of the sum of two consecutive positive numbers, sir.
Like?
We can tell that 25, 5 square, 25, sir, it is made up of 12 plus 13, sir.
180 per second, sir.
Very good.
Sir, there is a formula, sir. For first number,
For the first number?
We can tell that for finding first number, n square minus 1 by 2, sir.
N square minus 1 by 2.
And the second number is n square plus 1 by 2, sir.
How this 12 has come now with this?
Yes, sir.
5 square is 25 minus 1 divided by 2. So it is 24 by 2, hence we got 12. Is 25 plus 1 by 2, which is 26 by 2, it is 13. So here, when you observe, these are the two consecutive natural numbers. So the same concept we are going to learn now. Every square number is a combination of two natural numbers. We have the first number as n square minus 1 by 2 and the second number is n square plus 1 by 2. For example, 5 square is a combination of 12 and 13. Likewise, can I write every square number as a combination of two numbers which are consecutive?
Yes, sir.
I will give a square number now. If the square number is 49, can you tell the combination now?
That 24 and 25.
24 and 25. Because it is 7 square minus 1 by 2.
25, sir.
48 by 2 is 24. And 50 by 2 is 25. The combination is 24 and 25. So, all of you have understood this. If I give any number, any square number, I can make it as a combination of two natural numbers. What will be the combination of consecutive natural numbers here? 169. You should be fast in calculating.
Sir, 84 and 85.
Very good. 84 and 85 because. because it is 168 by 2, which is 84. 170 by 2, it is 85. It's very simple. Let's move on. Let's look at product of two consecutive even or odd natural numbers. If you have two consecutive even or odd natural numbers like a plus 1 and a minus 1, their product will be a square minus 1. This is one of the identity which you are going to learn in the later classes. A square minus b square is the combination of a plus b multiplied to a minus b. This is called as an algebraic identity. Let's look at an example to understand. If I consider two consecutive odd numbers like 21 and 23. This is 22 minus 1, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
This will be 22 plus 1. So this is 22 square minus 1. Is that all right now? So combination can be expressed as an algebraic identity a square minus 1. Let's see another pattern. 4 square is 16, 34 square is 1156, 334 square is 111556. Likewise, we have got few patterns with 7 ending at the units place, 49, 4489, 667 square is 444889. Likewise, another pattern is 7 times 9 is 63. 77 times 99 is 7623. 777 into 999 is 776223. You can see here it is following a pattern. 6 is maintained in the center, then 7s are there, 2, 3 are there. Likewise, we have 9 square as
so 7
even.
And 2 are increasing, sir.
Correct. This is a pattern. There is no rule for this. It is only the pattern which is seen among the square numbers. You need not remember this. Now we will learn finding a square number. To find a square number, we need to divide the number into two parts. Then we can solve it very easily. So for example, if a number is there, it's written as the combination of two numbers. I will give a numerical example, you'll understand. If 53 is there, it is written as the combination of 50 and 3. So when you find the square, we use an algebraic identity of this type. Here it is p square plus q square plus 2pq. The same thing. When any number is written as combination of a plus b, then its square is a square plus
b square.
2ab plus b square. This is also an algebraic identity which you are going to learn in later classes. Here, a square is nothing but 50 square plus 2 times of a into b. It is 50 times 3 plus b square, it is 3 square. Now to find square of
sir,
this number, it's easy.
2500 plus 150 plus 150 plus 9, sir.
So finding square number of a smaller number is easier. Here 2 times of 50 multiplied to 3 is 300.
Sir, it should be 3 times of 50, sir.
Correct, what is the sum?
So 2809.
2809, sir. In your method, if you are finding 53 square, you will multiply like this. When you know this formula, it becomes easy for us to calculate. That's the only intention. here when we divide into two parts, it's 50 plus 3. When we square that, we are going to get 2809. So any square number, to find any square number, we can make use of the formulae. One of the pattern we'll see, which are ending with 5. For a number ending with 5, we can use this pattern. Here, A is a symbol used for a number. Every number ending with 5, its square ends with 25. That is the reason why 25 is written here. We look at an example. If we have 25 square, it is A, which is 2, A plus 1 is 3. So 2 times of 3 is 6, multiplied to 100, 600 plus 25. So each time when 5 is the ending number, this 25 is added to the combination of 4 times of the next digit, 5. 4 times of 5 into 100. If you have 95 square, the 9 next digit is 10. So 9 multiplied to 10 is 90, multiplied to 100, 9000 plus 25. Like this, it becomes easy when we consider this digit and the next digit, 12 multiplied to 13 times of 100 plus 25. Observe, in each of these, 25 is being added. Next, we will see the Pythagorean triplet. Look at this statement. I'll explain. If two square numbers is also a square number, then these three numbers, they form Pythagorean triplet. One of the examples, simplest example for a Pythagorean triplet is 3, 4, 5. 3 square is 9, added to 4 square 16, we get the sum as 25, which is 5 square. Here is a formula to find out Pythagorean triplet. Any Pythagorean triplet will be of this form, 2p, p square minus 1, p square plus 1. In your textbook, they have given in terms of m, 2m, m square plus 1, m square minus 1. You can follow either p or in terms of m. Here, if one of the number is 6, I'll consider 2m as 6. I'll find out the value of m. So 2m is 6, m will be 3.
So I have a doubt, sir.
I'll explain, I'll come to you. M square plus 1 is 10, m square minus 1 is 8. So 6, 10, 8, these are the Pythagorean triplet. Yes, doubt.
Sir, we should only consider the number as 2p, sir, or 2m, sir.
Depending on the given number, say for example, if they give one of the number is 5, find the other two. In such case, if you take 2m as 5, there is no use. Because m value will be 5 by 2. It is not a proper number, it's not an integer. We have to consider it in another form. Say for example, I'll consider m square plus 1 as 5. So that m square will become 4, m value will become 2. If m is 2, I can find 2m, which is 2 times of 2, 4. M square minus 1, it is 2 square minus 1, which is 3. Now look at the number, 5, 4 and 3. 3, 4, 5 is a Pythagorean triplet.
Yes, sir.
Likewise, we have to think which one to consider. When we solve the problem of finding the two more members of the Pythagorean triplet, you will understand it. Now you just remember, this will be the format of a Pythagorean triplet. 2m, m square plus 1, m square minus 1. Okay? Next, we will move on to another very important concept called as a square root. It is exactly the opposite of finding square number. How to define the square root of a number? We know that 2 square is 4. So 2, when it is squared, we get 4. We can say that 2 is square root of 4. In other words, there is a symbolic way of representing square root. This is a symbol used for finding square root. Root 4 is 2. We will go into the details. Look at this statement. The square root is inverse operation of squaring. To find the number with a given square is called a square root. 2 square is 4, hence square root of 4 is 2. 10 square is 100, therefore square root of 100 is 10. If there are 2 square roots of any number, one is positive, another is negative. What does this statement mean? I'll tell you with an example. If I consider
1 of 4 is 2, sir, and minus 2 also.
Okay, sir. I have taken negative 3. Negative 3 multiplied to negative 3 is?
9.
Positive 9.
Positive 9, sir.
Correct, sir. If 3 is multiplied to 3, we also
nine,
get
sir.
The same 9.
Positive
so
nine,
we
sir.
Can say that root of 9 is negative 3 also and positive 3 also. So for any given square number, it will be having two roots. One of the root is a positive root and another root is a negative root. So we can mention it like this, plus or minus 3. What is the square root of 16?
4,
sir.
4
and minus 4.
Whenever it is asked, you can tell in terms of positive and negative, it's plus or minus 4. Root of 100 is plus or minus 10. It's compulsory to say plus or minus. In most of the cases, we take positive number. When we solve a question, if the number of students are to be found, we consider positive because negative 4 number of students will not be there. Likewise, according to the situation, we consider the value. Here, root of 25 is plus or minus 5.
Both plus or minus?
Correct, plus 5 as well as minus 5.
Minus 5.
This is a symbol used for square root. This is a symbol. To tell, in the next chapter, we are going to write a cube root. It is written like this. 3 is written within this space, it refers to cube root. Likewise, we have 4th root, 5th root, in general it is nth root. This is how we mention the symbol. There are three methods to find square root of a number. The first method is called as a repeated subtraction method. Second method is called as a prime factorization method, and the third method is called as a division method. Of these three, we usually follow either of prime factorization or a division. We do not follow repeated subtraction. Why we do not follow repeated subtraction, you'll understand
sir,
it.
Because it is very hard, sir. It's a long step to do.
It is a very lengthy process.
Let's look into this repeated subtraction. What is this repeated subtraction? Which number to be subtracted?
Sir, odd numbers, sir. Consecutive odd numbers, sir.
Consecutive odd numbers. Yes, consecutive odd numbers are to be considered for subtracting, and in each step we are going to subtract. So, as we know that every square number is a sum of consecutive odd numbers, starting from 1. So we need to find square root by doing opposite, that is by subtracting. By adding we get a square number, by subtracting we get square root. Let's see an example to understand. Subtraction.
Square root is 8 for 64.
8. Why 8?
Because 828 is equal to 64.
That's not the reason for repeated subtraction. What is the reason for repeated subtraction? 8 times we are going to subtract because 8 steps are involved. First step is 64 minus 1, which is 63. Here 1 is subtracted. Next we have to subtract next odd number, which is 3. Second step. Third step is 5 is subtracted. Fourth step is 7 is subtracted. Fifth step is 9 subtracted. 11 subtracted. 13 subtracted. 15 is subtracted. We have to continue this process until we get 0. Here, count the number of steps. Here, 8 steps are there. Since 8 steps are there, square root of 64 is 8. Imagine a number, say 1, 2, 2, 5. How many steps you have to follow?
35, sir. 35.
Correct, sir. 35 times you need to subtract, it becomes very lengthy. So we generally don't follow this repeated subtraction method. We follow other two methods, prime factorization and division method. Let's look into the prime factorization method. We have learned to find prime factors. When prime factors are found, we will make the combination, we make pairs, and then we calculate. For example, 784 is a given number. How do we find square root? How to find prime factors?
Sir, we should do prime factorization method, sir. And if it has a pair, sir, if it has a pair, then it is a square number, sir. If it does not have a pair, it is not a square number, sir.
Correct, you are right. Whenever we do prime factorization, remember one important thing. You should not go on dividing with any number you like. It has to be from increasing order. Here, since it is an even number, it is divisible by 2. I'll consider 2.
2, 3 are 6.
Yes, 2, 3 are 6. 9 are 18. 2. Once again, it is divisible by 2. So
yes, sir.
Keep dividing. 2, 1 are 2.
191, sir.
9 are 18. 6 are 12.
2 6 ja.
Correct. It's not one time, it is 6 times.
Yes.
Further, when it is divided by 2, 2 9 times is 18, 2 8 times is 16. Further, 2 4 times, 2 9 times. Now this number, why not by 3?
Because it will
not divisible.
Because the sum is 7, not divisible by 3. So 7, 7 times is 49. So 7, 1 time is 7. So always we follow this procedure of dividing by least prime number which divides it.
Here,
this 784 is, I will write as it is, 2 multiplied to 2. Multiply to 2, multiply to 2. 4 times 2 is there, followed by 2 times 7 is there. As I had mentioned, we are going to make pairs. Here is a pair. So 784 is nothing but 2 square multiply to 2 square multiply to 7 square. When we take square root of 784, it is square root of 2 square multiply to 2 square multiply to 7 square. In general, whenever we have some square on the power, we can club them write it as 2 times of 2 times of 7 whole square. Now the square root and square will get cancelled. We get 4 times of 7, which is 48.
48.
Sir, we can
48.
28, sir.
28, sir.
Good, good, good. Most of you are not sleeping. Very good. 28 is the answer. So how do we write in a symbolic way? We can write this as, therefore, square root of 784 is 28.
Yes, sir.
All of you have understood the method? We follow prime factorization. Then we are going to pair them. So two steps. The first step is prime factors. Akarsh, national anthem you can do later, sir. Prime factors we have to find, then we are going to pair them. These are the two steps involved.
Sir, also we can take 2 into 2 into 7, sir.
Is 2 into 2 into 7?
No, sir. 2 into 2 into 7, sir.
In shortcut, here 2 is taken, here 2 is taken, from this 7 is taken, these 3 are multiplied, we are going to get 28. This is a shortcut.
Yes,
but in an examination, if they ask find square root by prime factorization, please follow this method, sir. This is very important because this will be a 3 marks question. You need to write completely. Let's look at division method. We have certain procedure to be followed. First step is we start making pairs starting from the right. If the odd number of digits are there, then only one digit will be left out in the beginning. We have to mention bar on that. Then we have to find out a square number nearer to that. If you look at these steps, you may not understand. However, I am just giving it. We have to solve the question, then you will understand it better. Now we have a question here. Find the square root of 729. What I have to do is, I will write 729 and I will start making groups. Here, the number of digits you observe, the number of digits are?
3, sir.
3, which is an odd number. So these two are considered as one group. This is another group. So in this division method, we are going to write it like this. The nearest square number to 7 is 4.
2.
4, 4. 4 is a square number. How do we get 2? We get 4 by multiplying 2 2 times.
Yes, sir, 2 times.
4, 4 to be subtracted. Here is subtraction. 7 minus 4 is
3.
Next, we have to consider this group. If you not consider 2 alone, we have to consider the group. 2 needs to be considered. Now the number is 329.
Sir, 2 plus 2.
Here we need to add this 2. On the quotient, we had written 2. So this 2 should be added. 2 plus 2 is
4.
4,
sir.
Now we have to consider some number.
47,
4 is the tenth place. If I consider 7, 47, 7 times, it is 329. So 7 should be mentioned over here, 329, and the remainder becomes 0.
Zero.
So in the division method, these steps are followed until we get the remainder 0. So 27 is the square root of 729. Why this method is considered as an important method, I will tell you.
Yes.
This method is considered as very important because square root of any number is found. Any number is found using this method. In your class 9th, you start with finding square root of 2. To find square root of 2, you will write it as 2 point followed by so many zeros. Then you are going to make groups. Nearest square number is 1.
Fine, sir. Sir, please make PDF and put this into
1.4142, so many digits we get. Here, this 2 is not a prime number. 2 is a prime number, it is not a perfect square number. So, be it a square number or a non-square number, this method of division is followed. So this method is very important. Understood?
Yes.
You have many questions related to finding prime factorization method and division method. Both the methods are included. So we will understand it when we solve many questions. Abhinav, what is the doubt?
Sir, after writing 4, how 7 came there?
7, where? Here. I have to consider the combination 47 times of 7.
Yes.
Here, yeah. We have to consider this combination 47 into 7. We get 329. This is a method followed. You will understand it better when we solve many questions. All right.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The last concept of this chapter is estimating. We know the meaning of estimate. Here, sometimes we have to estimate the square root of a number if it's not possible to calculate the exact square root. Estimate the square root of 300. How do we estimate it? We
the nearest,
that, nearest square number we have to consider, correct?
Yes, sir.
We know that 400 is a square number, root 400 is 20.
Yes, sir.
Just after this, which square number should be considered?
29.
29, huh?
19, sir.
What is 19 square?
361.
361, sir. What is 17 square?
289. 280. 289.
So between these two it lies?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Correct? So I need not consider 20. I have to consider these two.
It lies. Sir, no, sir. It lies between 19 and 20, sir.
19 and 20, sir. This is 300, no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Also comes,
sir. So, between these two only, it lies?
19 square. 19 square, sir.
17 square and 18
square. No, sir. Between.
Between.
Square and 17 square.
17
square. Sir, it will lie between 17 square and 18 square, sir.
Sir, 17.32, sir.
Is it?
Yes.
So I should not consider 19 square. I have to consider 17 and 18 square, isn't it?
Sir, answer is 17.32, sir.
A rough estimation is done like this. Approximation of a square number. 17 square is 289. And 18 square is 324. So between these two numbers, there is 300. So to
it will lie between these two numbers.
Yes,
sir.
It is 17 point something we can say. Say it.
Sir, 17.32 is there, sir.
What we have okay, to write sir. After point, sir?
Don't write anything. You have to just estimate that the value or square root of 300 lies between 17 and 18. That's what you can write.
if question came exam to estimate the square root of 300, sir, then we have to write the it comes between 17 square and 18 square.
Yeah, correct.
We should write this all steps, sir.
Let me tell how to find square root of 300. Suppose it is not an estimation question, how to find square root of 300. It is done like this. We have to make groups. Nearest square number is 1. 1 is obtained by multiplying 1 with 1. I need to subtract. On subtracting, we get 2 here. Here 1 should be added up. We get 2. Here next group should be considered. It is 200. Now with 2, I have to consider some number here. I will consider 7. 27 7 times.
Sir, can we consider any number?
It's 189. 189? Yeah, 189,
sir.
Yes, sir. So 189. When
189
is there, we subtract.
Yes, sir.
This will be
11.
Now there is no numbers here. What we have to do is 0.00, 0.00 should be considered. Place the decimal, consider the next places. 7 should be added, we get 34. Now, with this, 3, 4,
sir, I have to consider next number.
We have to double unit place, sir.
Somebody asked a question, why we have to take 7 only?
Yes,
what
sir.
If I consider 8, 28, 8 times if I consider, this will be 64, 6 carry, 8, 2 times 16 plus 2 is 22, it becomes larger, isn't it? We have to consider the smaller number to this number.
Nearest
smaller number we have to consider, so we are taking this one, not this. Understood?
Sir, always we have to double unit place only, sir.
Unit place?
Sir, in left side, sir, for 1 we have, sir, 2 is there, for 7, 40, 4 is there.
Each 40. Time we are going to consider the unit place, and here it should be 3. 3 times. 3 for each 3, multiply to 3. This will be 9, 12, 1 carry, it becomes 10, 1029. Understood?
Understood.
Here something we get. Again, next places we have to consider with two zeros. This is a method, division method.
7,100.
Sir, if it is irrational number, sir, we cannot find the square root now, sir.
If it is irrational number, we can find an approximate square root using division method. Remember, For class 8, you will be given a perfect square only to find in division method. They will not give any number. This, in general, I have said, this you are going to learn in class 9th. In 9th, division method, we are going to find a square root of any number.
Sir, for real numbers, are there square roots, sir?
All the numbers are considered as real numbers, be it an irrational, are rational, it's called as a real number. We can find square root of any real number.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
With this, I'm going to take one question of exercise. We will complete this first question and we'll end the session. Look at the question here. What will be the unit digit of the squares of the following numbers? If this number is squared, what will be units place?
9.
Sir, 9.
9, sir.
Sir, 9 or 1.
9 or 1.
I am not asking a square root, sir. Square of. Isn't
sir,
it? It's square
unit
of.
Place is 1, sir. So 1 into 1, 1, sir.
Correct, sir. Units place is 1. Here the units place
four,
is
4, sir.
4. In this, four. The units place is 1.
21.
9,
for
sir.
This, it is 9. For this, it is 6.
Six.
For this it is
9.
For this it is Here it is 0.
Sir, 5.
We have written the numbers here. What do you conclude from this? If any number is ending with 1, it ends with 1. If a number is ending with 9 also, it ends with 1. So if a number ends with 1 or 9, the square number will be having 1 in the unit's place. If the number is ending with 3, its square ends with 9. If a number has got 4 in the unit's place and 6 in the unit's place, it ends always with 6.
6. 7 also it went with 9, sir.
3 and 7.
7, correct, sir. 7 also ends with
9.
No, 7
nine,
ends
nine,
with
9. 9, sir.
Okay. Sir, there is 5 and also it ends with 5 only.
If any number has got 5, it ends with 5. If any number has got 0, it ends with 0. This is what we conclude from this result. A small question for you. This you can think. Just think.
Sir, because the digits are not, they are from 2, 3, 7.
Because they do, they end with 2, 3, 7 and 0. And odd number of zeros.
If any number ends with 2, 3, 7, 8 or odd number of zeros, it will not be a square number. Is first one a square number?
No, sir.
Second one?
No, sir.
How about this, sir?
No, sir. Fourth one, no.
Fifth one,
no.
No, sir. 64 is 8 times of 8, no?
Odd numbers of 0 are there, sir. Three zeros are there.
Very good.
No, sir.
So the reason is if a number ends with 2, 3, 7 or 8, or else if it contains odd number of zeros, it will not be a perfect square.